Now, fool, there's something else we have to decide. We have to decide
which articles of faith and which commandments are best for our new church, our people, so they can walk in good ways.
Oh.
Thou shalt not what?
Play the fool.
Cover thy neighbor's wife.
Unless she's very pretty.
Or his manservant, maidservant, ox, ass.
Or your neighbor's wife's ass.
Oh, don't be facetious, fool. Did you know that in Exodus there are 613 commandments?
Thou shalt not suffer a witch to live.
Thou shalt have 3 feast days unto me a year.
Thou shalt never vex a stranger.
Whosoever lies with a beast shall be surely put to death.
Sheep shaggers. Pigeon fanciers.
Thou shalt not venerate the vicar of Rome.
Or lick his arse.
For thine is the kingdom,
the power and the glory.
Amen.
That's the doxology.
Doxology? It's the dog's bloody bollocks. I miss her, Will. I miss her so much.
I know. But this too shall pass. Why go on dwelling in darkness? You know that the land of the wounded king is only a parched wasteland, thirsting for rain and your majesty's grace.
Your Majesty, here are the 6 articles of faith upon which Your Majesty's Church of England is to be built and sustained.
Read them.
The first article concerns the truth of the transubstantiation of God. By the consecration of the bread and the wine at Holy Mass, there takes place a change in the whole substance of the bread into the substance of the body of Christ our Lord, and a change in the substance of the wine into the substance of his blood. The penalty for denying this is death by burning, even after recantation.
The second article concerns the withholding of the cup from the laity during communion. For if we offer them the blood of Christ, they will lose all their reverence for the holy sacraments, and the power of the blood would be washed away.
Quam oblationem quaesumus tu Deus, ut nobis corpus sanguinis fiat, dilectissimi filii tui.
The third article prescribes the continued validity of the vows of celibacy for all priests and nuns. For does St. Paul not say, he that is without a wife, he's solicitous for the things of the Lord, how he may please God. And he that is with a wife is solicitous for the things of the world, All priests who are now married must forthwith desert their wives or face the penalty of death.
The fourth article concerns the observation of the vows of chastity. A priest makes a vow of chastity, and any violation of that vow must surely be a sin against religion. To turn aside a vow to God and to writhe in the pit of fornication is to follow the devil willingly into the mouth of hell.
Accipite et manducate ex hoc omnes. Hoc est enim corpus meum.
The fifth article, herein decided, is concerned with the continuation of private masses, whereby good Christian people may receive both godly and goodly consolation and blessings for their souls.
Corpus Christi.
The sixth article confirms the importance of confession. Confitemus alter utrum peccata vestra. Confess your sins to one another.
Sanguinis Christi.
Anyone who disputes against these articles must now be considered a heretic, like those extreme Lutherans who now roam this land. The punishment for transgression is to be death by hanging, drawing, and quartering, as well as forfeiture of estates and property. And any man who decides to try to flee England in the face of these new articles will be considered to have committed treason and suffer accordingly the awful fate handed out to traitors.
Thank you, my Lord Bishop.
Your eminences are to be congratulated on your hard work and manifest wisdom. Here we have six articles we may adhere to with a clear conscience.
There is one final amendment. Henceforth, the Lord's Prayer will be altered to include the doxology. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory. Amen. My lords, eminences, your grace. Now that these matters have been determined, let us prosecute with absolute diligence all those who stubbornly stand against us.
These aren't six articles, they're a whip with six strings.
Cranmer, I have to send his wife and son back to Germany. Or be burned.
Oh, it's not just that, Mr. Rich. Private masses, confession, the body and the blood of Christ, these are Catholic measures. He's rolled back the reforms since the end of our Reformation.
Why?
Because in his heart, he has always been a true Catholic. Excepting this one thing, that he would have neither Pope, nor Luther, nor any other man set above him.
Ha 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 ha.